Today, I'll show you how to do your crypto.com crypto taxes. Hello, my name is Nelly. Welcome back to another integration video. Today, we're talking about crypto.com. This is an update video because it's been a long time since we talked about crypto.com and a lot of things have changed. So I'll tell you a little bit about them, then I'll jump into the integration. And then lastly, I'll show you where to get the necessary tax documentation. But yeah, without further ado, let's jump into it. So crypto.com was founded in 2016 and it's based out of Hong Kong. It is a very beginner-friendly wallet and it nails its fundamentals. Easy to use interface, low transaction fees, and great security rating. But that's enough about them. Let's jump into the integration. So first up, as always, log into your Koinly account. If you don't have one, don't worry. You can create one completely free. Head over into the wallets area and then click on add wallet. And then we're gonna find crypto.com and there it is. So we have two different options. I'll obviously show you both, starting off with the autosync. So that's the API. Keep in mind that only trades in the last 6 months will be imported. So if you have trades, you know, older than that, you'll have to find a different way to get the information, most likely through the CSV file, which I'll show you after this. Okay, so on crypto.com, in the left corner, we're gonna click on settings, then we're gonna go on API keys, and then we're gonna type in, or we're gonna click on create a new API key, give it a label, something like Koinly, and then you'll get your two-factor authentication. So type that in, and then you'll get your key and secret. So here is your API key. Make sure to copy and paste that into Koinly. And then here is your secret as well. Copy and paste that and click secure import. Okay, so that's one route you can take. Another route you can go down is the import from file option. So click on that. And then we're gonna head back on crypto.com. We're gonna click on wallet. And then here we're gonna need three different files. So we're gonna go on transactions. And then we're gonna select a time frame. Keep in mind that the time frame is only 30 days, so you'll need to export multiple files to get your entire transaction history. So transactions is one file you'll need, or one type of file. You'll probably need multiple files. The other one you'll need is deposits and withdrawals. This one has a 180-day max, so you'll probably need less files, but you'll still probably need at least two. And then if you've had this account for multiple years, you'll need multiple files. So make sure to select your time frames, get all that information and export. Okay, so that's two of the three files. The last one you'll need is the trade history file. So on the left side, you're gonna click on orders and then we're gonna go on trade history. And once again, keep in mind, this one is a maximum of 180 days. So you'll need several files. Make sure to export those and then simply take those files and drag them, drop them one at a time into Koinly. Okay, in the mobile app in the top right corner, click the little clock with the dollar sign. And then here, once again, top right button again. And now we're going to export our transactions. Obviously, select a time frame that's appropriate for your needs. So whether it's 1 year or you need to import your entire transaction history over multiple years, make sure to set that correctly. And then we're gonna click export to CSV. And there is your file. Download it and drag and drop it into Koinly. And once your data is imported, whether you use the CSV route or the API, it's not relevant. You're gonna go into your transactions area and check underneath hood, making sure everything is sitting correctly with you. You know, if you have any kinds of staking, making sure that stuff is tagged correctly, send to pool, send from pool. And then once you're finally happy with that, and you get one final summary in the tax reports area, so your capital gains, costs and expenses, income, all that stuff. And then when you're ready to check out, scroll on down and select a tax report appropriate for your needs. And we have plenty of different tax reports. So for the US, we have the IRS Schedule D, Form 8949. You can also export to TurboTax, both online and desktop versions. We have reports for UK, Sweden, Norway, France, Switzerland, Australia, and then finally, Canada, Germany, and other countries. We have the complete tax report, which keep in mind is a document you can print off and give directly to an accountant, and they will combine it with your other tax documentation. Or alternatively, you can invite them to Koinly to set up their accountancy firm here with us. Lastly, check your country's rules and regulations because this tax report might be deductible. But that'll do it for today's video. If you have comments, questions, concerns, I'll leave a bunch of different resources down below, starting off with the Koinly Help Center with countless different crypto tax related articles. We have a forum section if you'd like to talk to members of our community as well as our staff. We have a feedback section if you're having any issues with our software. And then lastly, if all else fails, send us a message directly and we'd love to help you out. But I do hope you found this video helpful. If you did, consider dropping a like, subscribing for more crypto content, and I'll see you next time. Peace.